Ghumar to Ghewar, royal history to rich melody, deserts to lake. The royal state of Rajasthan has it all. The state has another very important thing, very calculative voters. Rajasthanis are known for giving a fair and square chance to both the major political parties in the country over last three decades. In the state, they choose their government alternatively, and at center level also, they send maximum MPs from the same party which forms the government in the state. But despite all these calculations, the people of the state are still struggling for basics. Farmers' crisis, unsafe women, unemployment, crippling small-scale and cottage industries are some of the issues plaguing the state. As the state is all set to go for polling on 29th of April and 6th of May, these are some of the voices we get you from Rajasthan.
The display of these breathtakingly attractive precious stones used to be a common sight in Jaipur, the Pink City, the capital of Rajasthan. Jaipur is known for its small, medium and cottage industries. Gems and jewellery is one of them. But this industry no longer prospers the way it used to. The skilled hands which shapes and cuts these gems are now unable to feed themselves. Thirty-year-old Tanzeem Bano is a gem cutter who lives in Jaipur's Ramganj. Her art can barely help her make ends meet.
नोटबंदी से पहले अगर मैं 100 का काम करती थी ना तो अब मैं 20 रुपए का करती हूँ. इतना फर्क हो गया. अब हिम्मत नहीं है काम करने की. तो अब ऐसा लगता है इतना सारा काम करूँगी तो मुझे 20 रुपए मिलेंगे. और पहले थोड़ा सा करती थी तो 100 रुपए मिलते थे. नोटबंदी से पहले थी कला की कीमत, अब नहीं है.
Tanzeem has four children. Her husband is also out of a job and she has to look after her family. Years of gem cutting has affected her hands. Tanzeem isn't the only one. She took us to the house of Sultana Begum. Dilapidated stairs, damaged floor covered with stones and tin shed. This is where the 55-year-old gem cutter lives. After demonetization, she couldn't earn even 20% of what she used to earn. She and her family now run a small food stall.
और ये अब इस वक्त बस दिन भर चलते ही रहता है काम, बर्तन धोना, ये करना. इस वक्त तो पका के नहीं मरते हम.
And after all the hard work, this is what she earns.
रोटी खा लेते हैं, बाकी कर्जदार ही कर्जदार हैं हम. इतना शाही काम था हमारा नगीनों का, और कहाँ वेटर की नौकरी पे आ गए हम.
Traders are also facing several issues. Along with GST and demonetization, they cite more reasons responsible for their poor condition.
जो चाइनीज अपने यहाँ पर एंटर हुए इस काम में, उन चाइनीजों में सबसे बड़ा फर्क पड़ा कि वो यहाँ से लगभग 70% रॉ मटेरियल वो लोग ले जाते हैं यहाँ से. अब जब वो लोग ले जाकर वहाँ पर उसकी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करेंगे तो लाजमी बात है अपने पे बहुत फर्क पड़ता है इंडस्ट्री पे यहाँ पर.
It is not just the gems industry. The business of small traders of handicraft, handloom and textile is also in a crippled condition. Jaipur's world famous quilts aren't getting enough buyers now.
Notebandi aur GST se ye 30 se 40% ka व्यापार में गिरावट आई है. इसके अलावा पिछले तीन साल में इतने बड़े स्टोर जयपुर में आ गए. इन लोगों की पॉलिसी क्या है, छोटे व्यापारियों को एक तरीके से क्रैश करने की होती है.
स्किल्ड वर्कर्स आर फोर्स टू टेक मीनियल जॉब्स. स्मॉल ट्रेडर्स आर लुकिंग फॉर अल्टरनेटिव्स एंड कॉटेज इंडस्ट्री इज बैडली हिट. दिस इज द कंडीशन ऑफ माइक्रो स्मॉल एंड मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेस इन राजस्थान. Government at both state and center level claims that it has taken appropriate steps to keep these MSMEs alive, but clearly it's not enough.
The rural part of the state also has its own share of challenges. Farmers' crisis is one of the biggest challenges in rural Rajasthan. This is Hazari Devi. She lives in Rajasthan's Bundi. Hazari lost her husband in January this year. Hazari's husband, Chitarlal Megwal, was a 55-year-old farmer, and Hazari just can't come to terms with the circumstances under which her husband died. Her husband, like all the other farmers of his village, used to work on his farms at night, because that's when Handia Kheda gets electricity. On that fateful winter night, Hazari's husband left the house to water the farms. The temperature was below 5 degrees Celsius. He did not return home that night, and in the morning, he was found dead in his fields. Doctors told the family that the chilling night claimed his life. Meanwhile, the family hasn't got any help from the government.
सरकार ने अभी तक हमारी कोई मदद नहीं की है और कोई वादा भी नहीं किया है हमसे और हम मैं थोड़ी कर रहा हूँ मेरे हिसाब से कुछ कार्रवाई अगर वो पोस्टमार्टम रिपोर्ट आ जाएगी तो फिर कहीं मंडी कमेटी का वो फार्म भरूंगा तो वहाँ से अगर कोई सहायता मिल जाए तो बात अलग है नहीं तो अभी तक कोई सहायता नहीं करी.
Despite such heartbreaking tragedies, both the Congress and the BJP claim that they have done everything possible for the farmers.
Hamari sarkar kisanon ke liye ek ke baad ek thos kadam utha rahi hai.
Maine Chhattisgarh ke kisanon ko vaada kiya tha, Madhya Pradesh ke kisanon se vaada kiya, Rajasthan ke kisanon se vaada kiya. Theek hai, kaha tha na? Maine kya kaha tha? 10 din mein ho jayega. Kitne din hue? एक दिन हुआ दो स्टेट्स में हो गया मतलब 10 गुना बेहतर परफॉर्मेंस करके मैंने दिखा दी.
बट दिस इज द रियलिटी ऑफ द फार्मर्स ऑफ हांदिया खेड़ा विलेज.
सबसे भयंकर समस्या है यहाँ पर पानी की है और रास्ते की भी है और लाइट की भी समस्या है यहाँ पर और यहाँ के लोगों के पैसा भी बहुत कर्ज चल रहा है और सरकार ने अभी जो पैसा दिया है उसे कुछ भी नहीं हुआ है. बहुत से लोगों को तो एक रुपया भी नहीं आया है और यहाँ के लोगों की फसल को कम दाम में खरीदते हैं.
आंटी ये दोनों पार्टीज कह रही हैं कि हमने बहुत काम किया है किसानों के लिए, हमने किसानों को सुखी करने के लिए बहुत कोशिश करी है,
हमारे लिए तो कुछ भी ना किया. राशन जब सुख बढ़िया जब सुख काई भी न मिले काई भी.
बीजेपी सेज दैट इट हैज डन एवरीथिंग टू इंश्योर दैट द अग्रेरियन क्राइसिस एंड्स. कांग्रेस सेज दैट फार्मर्स वेलफेयर हैज ऑलवेज बीन इट्स प्रायोरिटी. बट इफ बोथ द पार्टीज व्हिच हैव रूल्ड द कंट्री हैव डन सो मच फॉर द फार्मर्स, व्हाई द फार्मर्स ऑफ राजस्थान आर फोर्स्ड टू अंडरगो सच हार्डशिप्स, व्हाई द फार्मर्स ऑफ राजस्थान आर डाइंग अंडर सच सर्कमस्टेंसेस.
Farmers' woes don't end there. Farmers are also reeling under huge debt. During the assembly elections, Congress had promised a complete loan waiver in Rajasthan. However, aggrieved farmers in the state claim that loans of only cooperative banks were waived, which accounts for only 17% of the total farm loans in the state. They believe that it was a facade put up by the Congress government, just like the BJP government. This man showing us his bank passbook is a 50-year-old farmer from Kucheri village of Nagaud, Rajasthan. Madan Ram took a loan for farming. consecutive years of drought didn't let Madan Ram pay off his loans. And now he is waiting for the government to fulfill its promise of farm loan waivers.
माफ तो कहीं नहीं किया सरकार ने सौदा में लियोड़ा है ढाई लाख रुपया है माफ सरकार ने कुछ नहीं किया
Farmers in Kucheri feel that the loan waiver promise is a facade.
Cooperative bank के 17% किसानों को लोन दिया था बाकी 83% को तो कॉपरेटिव का लोन है नहीं किसान के तो बाकी किसानों का तो माफ हुआ नहीं उसमें भी 17% के अंदर हर किसी किसान को 10-20 हजार रुपए लोन दिया था 50 हजार किसी के माफ नहीं हुए
It's not just Madan Ram and Jay Prakash. There are many more farmers who are under debt and waiting for the government to walk the talk.
क्या किसानों की कर्ज माफी राजस्थान में हो रही है?
नहीं हो रही है.
नहीं हो रही है. नहीं हो रही है कर्ज माफी.
आपने कितना कर्जा लिया हुआ है?
3 लाख.
और कितने वक्त पहले कर्जा लिया था?
2 साल पहले.
क्या आपको कर्ज माफी सर्टिफिकेट मिला है या बोलने वाले हैं देंगे ऐसा कुछ हो रहा है?
नहीं कुछ नहीं हो रहा.
सर आसपास के गांव में भी क्या यही हालात है किसानों की क्या सबने कर्जा लिया और किसी की भी कर्ज माफी हुई है या नहीं?
कर्ज माफी किसानों की समस्या का हल है ही नहीं. कर्ज माफी नहीं हल. मिनिमम सपोर्ट प्राइस जो तय करता है वो मिनिमम सपोर्ट प्राइस तय करने का तरीका बदलना चाहिए.
अनकेप्ट प्रोमिसेस ऑफ लोन वेवर नो प्रॉपर MSP लैक ऑफ वाटर सप्लाई फॉर इरिगेशन डिप्लीटिंग लेवल ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर एंड ड्राइंग ट्यूबवेल्स These are some of the challenges faced by the farmers of Rajasthan. Governments keep changing, but the fate of the farmers of Rajasthan remains the same.
Another big issue, equally prominent in both urban and rural parts of the state, is unemployment. 23-year-old Kavita Gautam has done her MA in History and Public Administration. But despite having a master's degree, she was unable to get a job. She is now doing a diploma in fire safety, hoping that after this diploma, she will be able to get a job. In the meantime, she is working in her father's farm. After unsuccessfully applying for an unemployment allowance, Kavita is left angry, dejected and feels let down by the system.
बेरोजगार हूँ तभी तो खेत में गई नहीं तो क्या लेने जाती? और मेरा उसमें सुविधा में नंबर आने वाला था जो अभी तक भी नहीं आया
The inability of governments at both the center and state levels to curb unemployment has left youth like Kavita completely disillusioned.
मैं तो बोर देने नहीं जाऊं मैं क्यों टाइम वेस्ट करूंगी मेरा नौकरी भी नहीं मिलती हम तो जनरल हैं जो हमारे 80% टूट दिए
Like Kavita, Mukesh's story is similar. Mukesh is from Kucheri village of Jodhpur's Nagaur area. He is a graduate and a diploma holder. Mukesh too applied for an unemployment allowance but did not receive even that.
बाद में डिप्लोमा किया और उसके बाद में ग्रेजुएट हुआ नागौर से ही और बाद में मैंने 2 साल से करीब और मैं गवर्नमेंट जॉब और प्राइवेट जॉब के लिए तैयारी कर रहा हूँ लेकिन कभी कहीं जाता हूँ तो या तो जान पहचान होती है वहाँ मिलती है और जहाँ जाता हूँ कहीं पर कहते हैं अभी टाइम नहीं है वो खाली जगह नहीं है
Providing jobs and unemployment allowances to the unemployed youth in the state were one of the biggest poll promises made by Congress in Rajasthan. BJP at center level is already receiving flak for the unemployment condition in the country. Despite all this, both the parties claim that they are doing everything to curb the issue. But the young people of Rajasthan, specifically rural Rajasthan, People like Kavita Gautam, they beg to differ.
Increasing crime against women is another challenge in Rajasthan. The National Crime Record Bureau report says that the state ranks 4th in crime against women. And age-old barbaric rituals such as witch hunting continue unabated in the state. This lane in Kandeda village of Ajmer's Kankeri area has witnessed something very cruel and barbaric. This is the house of 40-year-old Ramkanya Devi Regar. Ramkanya was a widow and lived here with her 15-year-old son. Barely a few months after her husband died, she was declared a witch by her relatives.
This is the house of 40-year-old Ramkanya Regar. She was allegedly killed by her own relatives after she declared her a witch. Now, this entire passage where you can see that how there are houses very next to each other, very close to each other, none of the neighbors of Ramkanya Regar is ready to tell that how exactly she died. All of them have only one thing to say, that on the day of the murder, they were not here. Every single house, every single neighbor is saying only one thing, that they don't know what happened. But if police has to be believed, according to the FIR, Ramkanya Regar was not only declared a witch, but she was allegedly beaten up by her relatives. In this particular passage only, she was paraded naked, and all those atrocities she was subjected to, according to the police, resulted into her death.
All this happened in the narrow lane where the houses are right next to each other. But apparently, no one saw anything. Every single neighbor of Ramkanya claimed that they were not home that day. Finally, we managed to find someone courageous enough to tell us about that fateful day.
पुराने जमाने की चीजें अभी भी चलती हैं क्या यहाँ पर?
चलती हैं मैम.
क्या बता दी भाई? मानते हैं लोग इन सब चीजों में?
नहीं, जो आप बोल रहे हैं वो उनको मानते हैं. आप पोस्ट में चलता है, 100% चलता है.
तो डाकन वाकन आती कहीं मारे?
नहीं, कहीं की डाकन आवाज कोई भी जरी नहीं, कोई नहीं.
तो यहाँ पे अभी भी मानते हैं इन सब चीजों को?
हाँ.
18 लोग माने हैं डाकन मैन इन सब चीजों में?
जनरली माने हुए ना.
Crime against women in Rajasthan is a big challenge in the state. National Crime Record Bureau report says that the state stands at number 4 in crime against women. Age-old barbaric rituals are still followed in the state, and witch hunting is one of them. In 2015, a law was passed preventing witch hunting and criminalizing the act, but it still continues unabated. Experts blame the lack of political will for the ineffectiveness of the Witch Hunting Act.
तो कन्विक्शन तो हमने कोई सुना नहीं. 130 के आसपास मामले आए हैं. 16-17 में दो साल की अवधि में ही 127 के आसपास केसेज आए, ऐसा मुझे रफली याद है. और कभी कभी मीडिया में इस पर कैंपेन किया गया है, मीडिया ने ज़रूर इस पर कैंपेन किया है, उसको छापा है. इतना आने के बाद भी दोनों पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज ने साइलेंस दिखाया, उन्होंने उसको उस तरह से क्रिटिसाइज नहीं किया.
Unfortunately, there are many more Ramkanyas who are humiliated, tortured and killed in the name of witch hunting. Neither the authorities nor society comes to their rescue. While talking about the condition of Rajasthani women, it is difficult to ignore their participation in politics. Representation of women candidates has remained abysmally low this elections, more so in Rajasthan. In fact, an ordinance passed by the previous Rajasthan government discouraged many women from contesting elections, even at the panchayat level. This is Chanda Devi Sharma from Ramnagar village of rural Jaipur's Chaksu area. A housewife, a mother, a grandmother, a daughter-in-law and a mother-in-law. Chanda Devi plays all these roles. But there is more to Chanda Devi's personality. There is one more role that she has always wanted to play. Chanda Devi wanted to enter mainstream politics. In fact, she planned to contest for Gram Panchayat elections for the Sarpanch post. But unfortunately, she didn't qualify.
जर्नल की सीट तो आ गई, लेकिन शिक्षा की वजह से हम वंचित रह गए, क्योंकि उसमें शिक्षा अनिवार्य थी 8वीं पास की, तो मैं 8वीं पास नहीं थी, इसलिए मैं रह गई. मैं 10वीं पास नहीं थी, लेकिन मेरे को थोड़ा बहुत अनुभव था, मैं कर सकती थी काम. मेरे को विश्वास था कि मैं कर लूँगी, 5 साल तक मैं पूरा काम कर लूँगी सरपंच का, लेकिन रह गई.
An ordinance passed by the Vasundhara Raje-led government kept Chanda Devi Sharma and many more women from contesting for the sarpanch post.
Assembly law passed kiya ki 8th se kam padha likha koi bhi vyakti isme participate nahi kar payega, chunav nahi lad payega. It means that you are denying 48% women folk.
The new Congress government in the state reversed this decision. But by then, many aspiring women sarpanch lost their chance and 5 years.
Rajasthan mein 7 seats aisi rahi jahan pe koi bhi mahila jan pratinidhi us 8th ki yogyata wali 8 panchayaton mein mili nahi thi. To ye ek to sabse bada dikkat hua. Ek jo 2010 ke chunav the usme matra 97 mahilaen hain wo nirvirodh chunav chun ke aayi thi, jabki yahi shiksha ki anivaryata ke karan 2015 ke chunav mein 260 mahilaen hain wo nirvirodh chun ke aayi hai.
Both the major political parties in India have barely done anything to increase women participation in active politics. According to an inter-parliamentary union report, till 2014, there were only 11.8% women in the Lok Sabha and 11.4% women in Rajya Sabha. The 2018 economic survey showed that out of 4,118 MLAs in the country, women MLAs accounted for only 9%. The report also ranked India 148 out of 227 countries for the representation of women in executive government and parliament.
Both BJP and Congress claim that they motivate women to enter mainstream politics. But facts don't support their claims. Out of 25 Lok Sabha seats in Rajasthan, Congress has fielded only 4 women candidates and BJP has fielded only 2 women candidates.
Even with the change in state government in 2018, farmers, women and youth in Rajasthan say that nothing has changed for them. However, major political parties like to believe otherwise.
Government of Rajasthan has announced 18,000 crores worth of farm loan waiver in Rajasthan. We've had slabs for who's qualified and for how long they're unemployed. That data has been worked out, and whatever, I think the BJP government had a few hundred rupee allowance. We've increased that to 3,000 rupees for male and 3,500 rupees for females.
We worked in every sector and we have progressed with accountability in every sector. They would collect firewood and make food, so that would take time and that spoils the health of the women. We've got them free gas connections there. We've also created toilets for them.
So these were the stories from the royal state of Rajasthan. Will the Rajasthanis break their voting pattern this time? Or once again, will they stick to their calculated decisions? Will the elected representatives bring the much needed change in the state? Only time will tell. In Rajasthan, with camera person Rajesh Khade, this is Santhya for Mirror Now.